Hello, I welcome you all in this course on steam and gas power systems. Today we will start with the gas turbine cycle. Now, in a gas turbine, the working fluid is a gas. It can be air also, but normally the working fluid is gas. So far we have analyzed the steam turbines where the steam is the working fluid. In the gas turbines, because we are using gas and phase change does not take place during the entire cycle. In steam power systems, there is a phase change. Since there is a phase change, mass flow rate, less mass flow rate is required in those type of systems, because during the phase change, a lot of heat rejection or absorption takes place, right. So, heat interaction is more when there is a phase change, but since in the gas turbines, the entire cycle works taking gas as the working fluid, so there is no phase change in the cycle, so it is a single phase cycle. That is why the sensible heat transfer takes place in all the processes of the gas turbine. Due to this fact, the mass flow rate in the gas turbines is high, or large volume has to be handled in the gas turbines. That is why centrifugal and axial flow compressors are used in the gas turbines, which can handle the large volume, large bulk of the working fluid. Now, it works on the steam power cycle works on the Rankine cycle, the gas power cycle works on Joule's or Brayton cycle. So, if I draw the Joule cycle on pressure and volume diagram, it is going to be like this. Starting from 1 to 2. Now, isentropic expansion in gas turbine, state 1 to state 2, then 2 to 3 is cooling, or if it is open cycle gas turbine, in that case air is taken from the outside in the compressor. This process takes place inside a compressor. Normally centrifugal or axial flow compressors are used in gas turbines. And when the state 4 is attained, the constant pressure heat addition is done inside a combustion chamber. There is a separate component, and in all these processes, unlike IC engines, internal combustion engines, in gas turbines, all these processes, they too take place in different components. Expansion in a turbine, then compression in a separate compressor, then heat addition in a separate combustion chamber. There is a separate dedicated combustion chamber for adding heat to the working fluid. If we transform this on a temperature entropy diagram, then these processes, now this is pressure 2 and this is pressure 1. This cycle works between two pressures, pressure 2 and pressure 1. Right, and process 3 to 4 is isentropic process. So, 3 to 4 is isentropic compression, which takes place inside a compressor. 4 to 1 is heat addition, constant pressure heat addition, we get 1. And after state 1, again expansion takes place inside the gas turbine, that is state 1 and 2, that is for us to study. State 1 to state 2 expansion in gas turbine, because this produces the output. Now, part of this output is used for running the compressor, and these lines are not parallel lines, they are diverging lines, right, and the constant pressure lines. And this power generated in during expansion from state 1 to state 2 is part of that power is used to run the compressor to compress the gas. In a steam power system, only a pump is required, because when there is a phase change, the entire volume is converted into a very small volume or negligible volume, right. So, a small pump is required to just to increase the pressure of the water, feed water. But here, because we are dealing with the gas, the fluid is the gaseous state only. So, bulk of the fluid has to be handled. So, a substantial part of this output is consumed by the compressor. It is substantial. substantial part of the power generated or energy generated during expansion process is consumed by the compressor. Now, remaining part, this is work of the turbine and this is work consumed by the compressor. Now, first of all, we will try to find thermal efficiency of this cycle. That is the first thing we should do, as we did in the case of vapor compression system, vapor power system. Thermal efficiency means net work done divided by the heat added. So, net work done here is thermal efficiency is work done divided by heat added. Thermal efficiency work done, this is not the work of the turbine, but the net work done. So, it is work of the turbine minus work of the compressor divided by heat added. Work of the turbine is a, because it is always, it is an isentropic expansion process, right. So, work of the turbine is Cp T1 minus T2. But here pressure is not constant, but we are taking Cp. This taking Cp, there is often a confusion amongst the student. This taking this Cp does not mean that the pressure is constant. In fact, in isentropic process, work is gamma over gamma minus 1 P1 V1 minus P2 V2. This is the expression for work done during expansion, right. How we got this? Work done during expansion is Vdp from state 1 to state 2, right. If you use this formula, and work done is, and for PV raised to power gamma is equal to constant is followed during this process, adiabatic process, reversible adiabatic, that is isentropic process. So, if you follow this, use this equation, integrate this, you will be getting this expression, right. Once we have this expression, which is derived from this Vdp minus 1 to 2, right. P1 V1 is, because this fluid can be treated as an ideal gas, then P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. Sorry, P1 V1 is RT1. And RT1 here, we are, it is a cycle, it is a air standard cycle. We are not analyzing the gas turbine. It is a Joule-Brayton cycle, it is air standard cycle. In air standard cycle, the working fluid is assumed to be the air, right. So, here we are finding the thermal efficiency of air standard cycle. This is known as Joule cycle. Cycle or Brayton cycle. Joule cycle or Brayton cycle. So, now we can take P1 V1 is equal to RT1. So, gamma over gamma minus 1 RT1 minus RT2, and this can be gamma R over gamma minus 1 T1 minus T2. And if you further take this is nothing but Cp, right. So, Cp is the expression for this. It is nothing to do with the constant pressure process, right. So, work is Cp delta T. Now, here turbine work is Cp T1 minus T2. Work done by the compressor, work consumed by the compressor in fact, or work done on the compressor is Cp T4 minus T3. So, this much work will be taken out of this to run the compressor. And net heat supplied is, this is a constant pressure process, Cp, but it is also Cp T1 minus T4. Now Cp will be cancelled out. Sorry, T1 minus T4, okay. Because here we are taking air as a working fluid. But in actual gas turbines, what happens when the air is compressed? When the air is compressed, combustion takes place. And flue gases, so the burned fluid is burned, fuel is also mixed with the gases, right? So specific heat changes that we will discuss later on. Right now, we are discussing only a standard cycle. So, thermal efficiency is T1 minus T2 minus T4 minus T3 divided by T1 minus T4. Or if we can rearrange this, then T1 minus T4 minus T2 minus T3 divided by T1 minus T4, or it is equal to 1 minus T2 minus T3 by T1 minus T4. Okay. Now, what we will do? We will take T4 by T3. T4 by T3 is equal to P4 by P3 raised to power gamma minus 1 over gamma. T1 by T2 is equal to P1 by P2 raised to power gamma minus 1 over gamma, where P4 is equal to P1 and P3 is equal to P2. So, both the expressions are same. It means T4 by T3 is equal to T1 by T2. Right? Or T2 by T3 is equal to T1 by T4. Right? T2 by T3 minus 1 is equal to T1 by T4 minus 1. T2 minus T3 divided by T3 is equal to T1 minus T4 divided by T4. Or T2 minus T3 divided by T1 minus T4 is equal to T3 by T4, or is equal to T2 by T1. Now, we will be putting this here and we will be getting thermal efficiency as is equal to 1 minus T3 by T4, right. Now, T3 by T4 is nothing but 1 minus 1 over R raised to power gamma minus 1 over gamma, where R is P2 by P1, where R is P2 by P1. Sorry, here, yes, P2, this is P2 and this is P1, pressure ratio. So, R is P2 by P1. So, thermal efficiency of air standard gas turbine cycle is 1 minus 1 upon R pressure ratio raised to power gamma minus 1 over gamma, right. But this is for air standard cycle. In air standard cycle also, this is an ideal air cycle. When it comes to the actual Brayton cycle, when actual Brayton cycle, here we have not considered any kinetic energy of the gas. The total energy includes the kinetic energy also. We have taken only enthalpy, change in enthalpy, Cp delta T, right. But say here, in the entire process, the velocity of the gas is quite high. So, kinetic energy we have not considered. Second thing is, there are losses in the processes. So, this is no longer isentropic process. So, compressor will require more energy for compression. This is 4 dash, right. So, actual work in the compressor is Cp T4 dash minus T3, right. Similarly, during expansion, it is not a vertical line, it is an inclined line. So, it is 2 dash. So, work of the turbine is Cp T1 minus T2 dash. Third is, in the chamber also, in the combustion chamber also, there is a pressure drop due to flow resistance. And pressure is no longer P2, it is slightly less than P2. The expansion will start from here. So, that also we have not taken into account. So, actual cycle deviates quite substantially from the ideal cycle. But we need the this air standard efficiency for the purpose of comparing the performance, or we should have a base value of the efficiency. Only then we can compare the values of efficiencies of different turbines. So, it is very much essentially required, it is essentially required, but the actual thermal efficiency of the turbine will differ. Further, if we use this cycle for gas turbine power generation, then heat addition, we have taken Cp T1 minus T4, but actual heat addition will be Cpg T4 minus, sorry, T1 minus Cp T4, temperatures are in Kelvin, right. And this also will include mass of the fluid, mass of the fuel. It is 1 kg of working fluid is here, but here it is not 1 kg, it is 1 kg plus mass of the fuel burned with the 1 kg. So, 1 plus mf. So, these things we will take into account later on. Right now, let us solve some worked example on gas turbines. We have already taken into account Brayton cycle, actual cycle. Now, we will take the some numericals on this. So, starting with the first numerical, a gas turbine plant works between fixed absolute temperature limit 300 Kelvin and 900 Kelvin. Temperatures are already given in Kelvin. The absolute pressure limits being 100 kilopascal and 400 kilopascal. So, P1 and P2 are also given. The isentropic efficiency of compressor is 0.8 or 80% and the turbine is 85%, 0.85. Estimate the actual thermal efficiency of the plant and the power available for driving external load. So, if the fuel consumption is 1 kg per second and the calorific value of fuel is 42 megajoules per kg. So, first of all, we will draw the temperature entropy diagram of actual cycle. There are two pressures P1 and P2. This P1 is equal to 100 kilopascal and P2 is equal to 400 kilopascal. So, starting from P1, 1 to 2, but it is not an isentropic process as efficiency, isentropic efficiency 0.8. It is 2 dash, now 3, and this is 4, and this is 4 dash. Now, isentropic efficiency of compressor, now it has to be explained here. Isentropic efficiency of the compressor is actual work done and ideal work done. So, actual work done is more. So, ideally, what should be the work done in compressing the gas, that is Cp T2 minus T1, and actual work consumed is T2 dash minus T1. So, isentropic efficiency is equal to T2 minus T1 divided by T2 dash minus T1. Isentropic efficiency of turbine, here turbine actual output is less. Here actual output is, input is more than the ideal input. Here actual output is less than the ideal output. So, isentropic efficiency of the turbine is going to be Cp T3 minus T4 dash divided by Cp T3 minus T4, or it is going to be T3 minus T4 dash divided by T3 minus T4. Right. So, it is एक्चुअल, आइडियल, आइडियल, एक्चुअल. नाउ हियर द एफिशिएंसी ऑफ द कंप्रेसर इज 80%. ओके, नाउ इनिशियल टेम्परेचर, टेम्परेचर लिमिट्स, टेम्परेचर लिमिट्स मीन्स T1 इज इक्वल टू 300 केल्विन एंड अनदर लिमिट इज 900 केल्विन. सो T3 इज द हाईएस्ट टेम्परेचर, 900 केल्विन. नाउ इफ यू वांट टू हैव वर्क इन द कंप्रेसर, वर्क कंज्यूम्ड बाय द कंप्रेसर, वी शुड हैव द वैल्यू ऑफ 2', राइट? सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ T2. सो T2 इज T1 P2 बाय P1 raised to power gamma minus 1 over gamma. So T2 is 300, P2 by P1 is 400 divided by 100 raised to power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4, and this brings the T2 as 445.8 Kelvin. Now we have the efficiency 80%. So 0.8 is equal to T2 minus T1 divided by T2' minus T1, or T2' is equal to T1 plus T2 minus T1 divided by 0.8. We have the value of T2. T1 is already 300 Kelvin. We will put the value of T2 and T1 here, and we will get the value of T2', and this T2' is 482.25 Kelvin, right? Now after getting T2', we can calculate in similar fashion, we can get the value of T4' also, because these temperature values will be required when we will calculate the efficiency. So similarly, T3 by T4 is equal to 400 by 100. This is P3 by P4 raised to power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4, and this gives the T4 as 605.65 Kelvin. So now we have the value of T1, T2, T2', 3, T4, and T4', again efficiency of the turbine is equal to T3 minus T4' divided by T3 minus T4, or T4' is equal to efficiency of the turbine T3 minus T4 T3 minus T4'. So T4' is T3 minus. So now we have the value of T3. T3 is 900 Kelvin, and T4 we have right now, we have calculated, and we will get the value of T4', and T4' is 649.8 Kelvin. Now we have all the values of the temperatures, and these values will help us in calculating the efficiency of the cycle. Now here it is stated that if the fuel consumption is 1 kg per second, so mass of the air plus mass of the fuel, right, H3 minus mass of the air H2' is equal to mass of the fuel into calorific value of the fuel, right? So here we can find mass of the air and mass of the fuel, divide this by mass of the fuel. So this is mass of the fuel, mass of the fuel, mass of the fuel, mass of the fuel. Calorific value is 42 megajoules per kg, or this can be taken as 42,000 kilojoules per kg, because here we are dealing with the kilojoules, right? Now this gives the mass of the air and the mass of the fuel ratio is 97.88. Or fuel year ratio is here is 97.88 means per kg of fuel will require this much of air. Now, the work of the compressor is Cp T2 dash minus T1, right. Now, Cp is known to us 1.005, it is standard value for air. T2 dash we can take from here 482.2 and T1 is 300 Kelvin. And the work of the compressor is, work of the compressor will write here 183.16 kilojoules per kg. After this, we will calculate work of the turbine. Work of the turbine. Now, here mass of the fuel is also added at 3, mass of the air plus mass of the fuel. So, for 1 kg of air, the mass of the fuel will be, what is fuel ratio? Fuel air, so air fuel ratio was 97.88:1. So, 1 by 97.88 will be added here, right. And this is, this will give Cp T3 minus T4 dash. Since Cp of the gas is not given to us, otherwise Cp would have changed, it would have increased. But since the Cp of the flue gas is not given to us, we will assume Cp of the air here. So, it is 1.1 by 97.88, 1.005, T3 is 900 minus T4 dash is 649.8 Kelvin. And this will give the work of the turbine as 254 kilojoules per kg. But this work is not available to us. What is available for the use is difference of turbine work and compressor work. So, the net work here, so net work is equal to work of the turbine minus work of the compressor, that is 254 minus 183.16. Once we have net work with us and the mass of air is also with us, this is per kg of, this is kilojoules per kg of air, right. Mass of the air is also with us. Mass of the air is 97.88 for burning 1 kg of fuel. And we have the calorific value of 1 kg of fuel, that is 42 megajoules per kg, right. So, this will be multiplied by, in order to find net work, this will be multiplied by mass of the air 97.88 and this will be in kilojoules divided by calorific value, that is 42,000. When we take this ratio, the efficiency of the turbine comes around 16.5%. So, one thing what has to be remembered, that mass circulated in actual gas turbine cycle is not constant. Compressor is taking, sucking in air, but when the air enters the combustion chamber, mass of the fuel is also added. And both mass, the flue gases consist of the air and the burned fuel, it takes part in power generation in the turbine, right. So, that is all for today. In the next class, we will further discuss on gas turbines.